I've been trying to get access to the data inside my car and use it to do interesting things. For example, opening my garage door using a button inside my car, like this. Let me introduce you to my CAN bus framework. For the longest time, I wanted to access data inside my car and integrate it into my smart home. I could build very specific devices that do separate functions. For example, I could have hardwired my garage door opener to a button in the car and used it to open it, or a Wi-Fi device that reads my car battery and sends me alert when it's slow, which I actually did in a previous project. However, I wanted to make one generic device that can do multiple things at once. This is when I realized that I needed to hack my way into the car's network and sniff its data. On the hardware side, I need a microcontroller that allows me to tap into the car's CAN bus and is able to send this data wirelessly. Next, I wanted to make a plug and play device that connects to the car. This led me to create a gateway that simply takes all the CAN bus frames and send them wirelessly. As you might already know, for CAN frames, we're usually only interested in two parts, the ID and the data. And that's exactly what I extracted. But how would I send this data wirelessly without running a complex Wi-Fi stack? It turns out I already solved this problem in another project and I have a lot of experience dealing with it. It is my hub that I used for my very low power efficient contact window and door sensors. This hub used the zero configuration Wi-Fi free peer-to-peer ESP-NOW wireless protocol, which is a perfect fit for this project. Now that I know what I need, I picked the ESP32 microcontroller and the DevKit 1 board, since the ESP32 has a built-in CAN controller. I then started designing a shield for that board to add a CAN transceiver and a voltage regulator that steps down the car's battery voltage to a usable voltage for the ESP32. This allowed me to quickly connect to the car's CAN bus, confirm my concept, and extract the CAN frames. The gateway is kept to a minimum. It's one loop that reads CAN frames, extracts the ID and data, and broadcasts them over ESP-NOW using a custom data structure. I made a full video about this shield previously and it sold out pretty quick in my store. Since then, I made some minor changes and released the new version. I will leave a link to it. And that leads me to my gadgets. And now today's video sponsor, PCBWay. I have been using PCBWay for years, and they are my go-to manufacturer for all my prototypes. I've been averaging a week from the time I place an order to the time I have them in my hands. I'm very happy with the quality so far, and ordering PCBs have come a long way, especially for hobbyists. So I encourage you to give them a visit. I will put a link to their site down below. A gadget is the name I give to any device that can receive ESP-NOW messages from the gateway and act on them. For example, remember at the beginning when I wanted the ability to open my garage door using an existing button in my car? This suddenly became very easy to do. I built a device using an ESP8266 WeMustDIY mini board that listens to this ID. This is the ID for the right wheel on the steering wheel in my Tesla. And when it sees that I have that wheel pressed for more than 5 seconds, it triggers the relay shield, which is connected to my garage door opener. If you are curious about the wiring of the relay and the garage, I made a video a long time ago about this for a different project. I simply reused it. I created this gadget in less than an hour and I didn't even need to slice any wires. I simply listened to the proper CAN messages for that button. I'm already working on a dozen more gadgets and I'm sure there are other uses that I didn't even think about. One gadget that really stands out for me is this small dash I made for my Model 3. I have a gateway connected to my Tesla and an ESP32 board with a screen processing all the relevant IDs and showing things like range, speed, gear, and the battery state of charge. In upcoming videos, I will talk more about the gateway, how I made it, and the challenges I face, and even more gadgets. So come back if you're interested. Thank you for watching.